everybody, this is Christopher with Edgy Productions. Welcome to another edition of First Impressions, where I give you my first impressions of the newest offerings from some company. Today, it happens to be Forge World. Forge World has put up several pre-release models this week, so let's take a look and see exactly what they've got to offer. The first thing up on the list is Morgenthorg, a character miniature for the Blood Bowl line of models. Now, again, I need to caveat this whole video by saying I am looking at all of these items from an aesthetically pleasing point of view, as opposed to how good they are in a particular game or what they can do in a particular game. So, from a painter's perspective, I actually like Morgenthorg. Very, very interesting model, standard ogre-ish type miniature, very classic style. Aside from the football that he's holding in his hand, you could pretty much use this guy in any sort of a dungeon crawl adventure and probably get away with it. Very, very neat model. I've often kind of enjoyed miniatures where, for instance, the model might be missing a hand and they have some sort of weapon attached to that stump. I think it's kind of an interesting characteristic that they've found a way to utilize something that is no longer there. So that always kind of appeals to me. It's a very simplistic model. It's very nice. The lines are clean. It's very neat. I'd recommend at least taking a look at it. The only problem I've got with it is that it's 20 British pounds, which works out to about $26-$27 US currently. So, fairly expensive miniature for a single resin model, but again, aesthetically, it is a very, very neat looking miniature, and it's one that I would consider picking up and putting paint to. Now, the second offering from Forge World will kind of group together, because they've got three offerings here. They're all dwarven related, so I'll just kind of talk about all the dwarven stuff at once. The first is the Iron Hills Dwarves with Spears. This is a three miniature set for 18 pounds. Again, not too expensive, about $8 per miniature in the US market, looking about $23-$24. Again, I kind of like these miniatures. There's something pleasing to the eye when I see a miniature who has a very large shield, but it's strapped to their back so that their hands are free. It's a neat aesthetic that you don't see utilized that frequently in miniature form. I also really like the spears for these guys because they're not just a standard straight spear. They've actually got this neat little notch that's sort of cut out of it. And I think it adds a unique element to the models. Beyond that, they're just kind of generic dwarven miniatures. I will say that their armor, to me, does sort of look like a Bushido or a samurai-style armor in the way that it's sort of layered in various, it's almost a plate mail, but it's sort of hanging off as opposed to being a whole body plate mail. So it just gives it that sort of feudal Japan style look. So they're kind of neat, but overall, yeah, they're just sort of okay miniatures. Now, the Iron Hill Goat Riders is the third offering for the day. These are basically dwarves riding goats. It's a dwarven cavalry unit. I was not really all that impressed with this particular unit. I will say that the goats look kind of interesting, but the dwarves are just generic spear-carrying dwarves, and there's nothing really exciting about them. Plus, the price point on this one is just ridiculous. 45 pounds for this kit, which translates into about 55 US dollars. For that price, let me give you a couple of alternate suggestions, which I've never done here on First Impressions, but I would like to. First of all, if you're just interested in something fun and unique to paint, I would suggest checking out Privateer Press's Circle Ouroboros line. There's a particular kit in there called the Druid Mist Riders. In this set, you get five druids on the backs of rams, basically. They're leaping, they're jumping about, they're much more characterful than these dwarven units from Forge World, and the price point is almost identical. $60 US, but you get five miniatures as opposed to three. It's a much, much better deal. If you're not interested in druids and you are looking for something to put into a game and utilize these dwarven cavalry style miniatures, I would also suggest checking out West Wind Productions. They have two, actually three, mounted dwarven units. They have dwarves on horses, which I won't show you guys a picture of, and the more interesting units of the Ram Cavalry, which, let me get back to the, they're called Ramux Riders. You get three guys for 14 British pounds. So you're talking about $18 roughly for three miniatures. So you could take three boxes of those and equate to the same price point as you could for one of these Forge World models, and they look, truthfully, much, much cooler. And then, of course, if you really want to go for the fun stuff, try the Dwarven Shaven Cavalry, which is dwarves on pigs, which is, I mean, it's dwarves on pigs. What else is there to say? Last offering, or I guess there's two more. There is a what they call the Dane Ironfoot and Goat Rider Warband, which is basically four sets of goat riders plus a character miniature Dane Ironfoot. You've got an on-foot version and an on-cavalry version, so you get two extra miniatures technically, but the price point's 220 pounds, so you're looking at least close to $300 US for 14 miniatures. It's just astronomically priced, and I'll be honest with you, I don't really care how good-looking these miniatures are. That's excessive. Aesthetically, though, not too bad, but there are much, much better options out there. The last offering from Forge World today is the Ruined Watchtower of Amon Sul at Weathertop. Now, I love myself a good piece of terrain. I really, really do. And this one doesn't disappoint. It's a beautiful piece of terrain, very Stonehenge-esque in its appearance. According to the description on Forge World's website, it's 16 inches across, which is a sizable piece of terrain. That's a pretty big chunk of resin. Very, very nice-looking piece. Again, price point's a little hefty on this one, 255 pounds. You're looking 350 bucks plus on this one, so very, very pricey. If it was me, I could get the same quality, aesthetically anyway, from Fenrir Miniatures and their really, really nice terrain lines for a fraction, I mean a major fraction of the price of this one piece of terrain. A lot of neat looking stuff today, but I want to point out that there's always better alternatives from a painting standpoint. Now, if you're one of those people that is a gamer, then, and you've got to have this terrain in order to, you know, legally play, so to speak, then by all means, this is something that you might be interested in. However, aesthetically, from a painter's perspective, there are equivalents or betters to Forge World's offerings today out there, and I would probably pick those up before I would pick up any of this stuff. Although I do admit, I do like those dwarves on not the ones on cavalry, just the dwarven infantry. I love those spears. I may see if I can find some bits of those spears somewhere on eBay or something like that, because it is a neat feature. And the Blood Bowl guy is not too bad looking either myself. But just wanted to give you guys some quick first impressions, and as I said, some alternate possibilities, because I know that there are some out there that many of you may not know about, and so I wanted to kind of present those as a possibility if you're interested in picking something like this up, but something that looks better and has a lower price point. So, that's all I got for you guys today. I hope that you've enjoyed this somewhat lengthy version of First Impressions. Hopefully next time there won't be quite so many new models in pre-release, and we'll be able to do it a little bit more quickly. But again, I hope that you've enjoyed this episode. If you have any comments or questions, and I hope that you certainly do, because this has been one of the most interactive video sets that we've done here on this channel, definitely leave those down in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. I want to thank you once again for watching. I really, really do appreciate it. God bless you all. Have an amazing rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.